tal vez me amabas, pero ahora lo sé. Y ya yo no puedo esperar para verte otra vez. Cada vez que reviso el buzón, tengo que contenerme. Espero tus cartas con ansia de volverte a tener. Estoy en el cielo, estoy en el cielo, estoy en el cielo, y se siente muy bien, se siente muy bien. Ay, ay. Pensaba que tal vez me amabas, pero ahora lo vi. Quiero pasar más la vida esperando por ti. No te quiero un fin de semana o un día no más, porque espero que cuando regreses te quieras quedar. Estoy en el cielo.
I don't know what that dream is that you have. I don't care how far-fetched it might appear to be. I don't care how disappointing it might have been as you've been working toward that dream. That dream that you're holding in your mind, that it's possible. For you people who are running toward that dream's life has a special kind of meaning. It's possible for you to live your dream. It's necessary that you associate with winners, that you work your system, that you are relentless, that you never give up. It's you. You've got to take personal responsibility. You've got to make it your personal business.
The U.S. is my first home, you know. Then Ukraine is my second home. Then Nigeria is my third home. So, like, it's like I just lost my second home.
A San Antonio man is on a mission to help his soccer team escape the Russian invasion. February 2nd, Eleojo Okeme left the Alamo City to take his yearly trip to Ukraine. His team is based near the eastern border. Weeks later, all 64 members became refugees, uprooting their lives to head west.
Someone to wake me up, you know, so, like, just wake me up and tell me it's a dream, it's not happening.
Last Wednesday, Eleojo Okeme was urged by his wife in San Antonio to leave Ukraine, so he took his 8-year-old son and fled to Slovakia. The next day, the invasion began.
It was like early in the morning, they were still sleeping and they started hearing, like, you know, bombs.
Okeme owns the soccer team FC Dynamic, based in Kharkiv, a city near Ukraine's eastern border. He finances the club using money from his professional soccer contract with the San Antonio Runners.
I just started to give, like, minorities over there in Ukraine the opportunity, you know, to be able to make it over there.
As soon as the bombs started, Okeme began navigating his 64 players and 8 coaches out of the country. He used his remaining team budget to help them leave.
Some of them are in Hungary, some of them are in Slovakia, some of them are in Poland.
As of Friday afternoon, the remaining 28 players were still trying to escape. 12 were on a train, the rest arrived at the western border and were in line to cross. Some, he says, were forced to wait in line up to 2 days.
I, you know, really like to play the race card. Like, you know, I don't like to talk about that. I don't like to go there. But so many of my boys, you know, when they got to the border, you know, mainly the Polish border and the Hungary border, you know, like, some of them were on the line. And when it got to their turn, they told them to step aside, you know, just for the Ukrainians to cross over. So they had to step aside for like 5, 6, 7 extra hours.
Okeme spent Friday talking with universities in Slovakia because as his players compete, they're also going to school. His goal is to relocate his team and organization there.
I get those ones to cross over, you know, like that's when I'll be able to rest, because it's been horrible, because they are my family.
A GoFundMe page was created for the team. The money raised will help replenish the budget he used to help everyone escape. It will also benefit their schooling. Once everyone's relocated, Okeme will return back home to San Antonio. Visit Kens5.com to learn how you can help.
Here in San Antonio, Texas, we have official kickoff for the San Antonio Runners SC against the San Antonio Serve, who are obviously playing for the very first time here in San Antonio together. This is the San Antonio Runners home game of the season. And here with me to do the commentating analysis is Christopher Sanchez. Chris, how you doing tonight?
Very good, Christian. I am very much enjoying our time here at the stadium, and it's a pleasure to be with you here, Christian. And I'm just excited for a really great matchup between two San Antonio clubs. What are you seeing so far, Christian?
Well, I see a lot of excitement from the players themselves on both sides. And as you can see, we are just seconds into the game. And so far, both players during their warm-ups, they looked highly motivated and looking forward to this game. Let's see if we can try to bring up the players' list so we can give you that information.
It is hard not to be jerky.
Thank you so much. So, Christian, here we go.
For the San Antonio Runners, we have goalkeeper number one, Oscar Ceballos. Number 21, Javier Banda. Defender number three, Samuel Espinosa, also in the backfield. Number 9, Julio Franco, moving up to midfield. Number 10, Adrian Maldonado, joining him. 11, Jonathan Esquivel. And up front, we have number 12, Joseph Maldonado. Number 16, Jelani Moore. Number 17, Mi Tocayo Cristian Guerrero. Number 18, Jason Torres. And number 20, Alexander Milmo.
All right, and for the San Antonio Surf, at goalkeeper, we have Vincent Florio. And at defense, we have Diego Orozco, Jorge Encinas, Jose Chavez, and Eric Olvera. At midfield, we have Cohen Voss, Miggy Salazar, Felipe Perez, and Elias Daddy. And at forward, we have Alec Rodriguez and Christian Saxio. All right, here we go. And it seems that the Surf have controlled the ball on the defensive end, and they are trying to push the ball forward. What do you see, Christian?
So far, I see a little bit of movement from both ends. We'll have to look to see if the Runners can gain control of the ball. Most of the time, we've seen the Blues in possession, but in their own field. Slowly, we're moving up. So tonight, being the first home game of the season for the San Antonio Runners SC, we have special guest from Miss San Antonio, Abigail Velez, who will be with us tonight, helping us out with a couple of interviews and some halftime action.
The girls are slow compared to this.
Right now, we have a sideline throw-in for the San Antonio Runners. For the Naranjas, the orange. What do you think of the uniform, Chris?
Very, very close to the university here in San Antonio, but I feel like it has a connection also with Texas, and I just really enjoy their uniforms. But let's see. They got the Houston Dynamo colors too, and they're playing against an all blue kit.
How does the wide angle look?
Very, very well. They look very, very nice.
That is a good observation.
Yeah. Orange. I've been trying to keep it good.
Quite a popular color, it seems, in Texas. And I think it looks very good with the blue accents on the top, and it slowly fades through the rest of the uniform for orange. I really like it. What about the San Antonio shirt?
I'm glad it wasn't on me.
A little bit like Chelsea, would you say?
Chelsea, I think. You know, what's another popular blues teams that you can think of?
Let's see.
Chelsea. I
mean, Cruz Azul is the...
Cruz Azul, that's what I was going
that's
for.
That's coming to mind, but...
That's what I was going for, but...
But the Surf have their own style. They are pushing the ball forward. I see that Oscar Ceballos is looking to have his first action as goalkeeper, as
the
Surf are going to do a corner kick.
Here comes the first corner kick for the Surf. Low kick quickly rejected by San Antonio runners. Surf has to push back and regroup. Number 27 looking to change out the field. It's a very dangerous move when you're switching from left to right of the field and not seeing clearly whether it's going to be a play or not. That might be a mistake that the runners could be taken advantage of if that happens again.
Millauer is pressing, and let's see if they're able to take the ball away from the Surf.
Here the Surf on the right field, coming in on number 9. They clearly missed that by an inch or so. The runners are able to defend, and we have a foul in favor of the Blues. Here comes a direct kick for the Surf. That was a very close call for the runners. Number 21 getting it out of the box.
Miggy Salazar will... It looks like Miggy Salazar will attempt this free kick about 15 yards out.
He got a bunch of people in his way.
Looks like he'll be kicking with the right foot. We also have another player lined up. Not sure if that'll be a fake attempt. Lined up for the left footer. It almost seems that the ball is right in the middle of the field, so it could work out for both profiles. But we have a right kick! And we have an offsides. That does not count. We have an offsides. And clearly, the runners start sweating. The big drops little by little.
I got him.
Very good attempt. It was dangerous, but it seems that the runners' defense was also ready for this attack.
We'll go with Oscar Ceballos. A little bit of a background history, the goalkeeper number 1 for the San Antonio Runners. He grew up here in San Antonio, Texas, went to MacArthur High School, graduated of class 2018, and played for the Adams State men's soccer.
And the Surf continued to push forward,
and
their attack is stopped from the defense, and it is cleared out.
Guys, soccer is way faster.
Let's see if
cleared out by number 21, Matthew Banda there, who's doing a pretty good job in the last two plays.
They're way slower than guys.
Getting the ball out and saving the team from the opening score of the Surf. 7 minutes into the game now. Beautiful weather. A little bit cloudy, but beautiful weather here in San Antonio. Tonight, April 23rd. You guys are watching. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in for this first home game of the Runners SC. And thank you for all of your support. Go follow our Instagram page at SA Runners SC. Click subscribe and follow on our YouTube channels.
I did the same thing you were doing when I was
websites. Anywhere you can find us, share our links. So our players can get
for the last four games.
that motivation to win the games. Looking to cross, number 10, receiving it with the chest, looking up, but he found five orange shirts that they're not able for him to turn around, so the Surf are forced to play in the backfield again. Here comes a side throw-in for the Blues. Chris, I am not seeing a lot of activity for the runners at the moment in the upper field. What do you think needs to happen for the runners? The Surf seem to have a lot more possession of the ball.
Just the ball, at least. Like, I don't know how many yards. This angle's a little different. We're way further away than we are normally. We're normally closer to the field.
But I do see that the defense of the Surf is stopping most of the attacks so far. Let's see if Coach can create some type of strategy to get some more offense for the team.
Orange ball here on this side throw-in.
And the Surf are continuing to press forward, and it is stopped.
Dangerous play there, Chris. But also a very smart play when you are close to that line. Oh, nice filter pass. Will he get to it? Number 13 for the Surf. He's inside the keeper box, and it will be another corner for the Surf. As I was saying, dangerous diagonal pass to the top of the 18. That could be very costly if the runners are not able to keep up with those plays. But fortunately, the defense for the Orange is doing a pretty good job. Let's see what happens on this corner.
Yes, Christian, and Christian Sachschaug is gonna be attempting this corner kick, and let's see, this is already their second attempt in about the last 2 minutes.
It's a little bit windy. So he's gonna have to kick it in a little bit more inwards. Oh, dangerous bounce there in the pick. It will be another corner. We'll have to repeat that.
Corner shot.
Jelani Moore does head that ball out, and it will be another corner attempt.
Christian with the corner again. Oh, dangerous header there. I saw at least two.
Ooh. Very
Oscar
good
Oscar Ceballos right. With a great save. As you could see, there was four blue shirts with that ball, within range of that ball. That could have been an easy score for the Surf. Fortunately, Oscar was there to provide the block. San Antonio FC needs to pick up the head.
Let's see if they can create some type
dangerous
of
dangerous play there. That has to be a blue ball. Oh, that's not a blue ball. Okay. I'm sorry, I meant orange ball, but it will be a blue ball.
Eric Olvera.
The ref looked a little confused on that play, but Coach Mason Ranking starts to walk around and starts doing a couple of yelling to his players that they need to move the ball up to the field and stop playing within their own half.
Yes, let's see if we can see any type of attack.
Samuel Espinosa kicking it out right about the 15-yard line or 10-yard line into their own territory. Coming back again, the Blues putting up some pressure.
Ooh, kid faked me out.
we will see another attempt to throw the ball in.
Is that what's going on here?
Yes, let's see.
Oh, they're complaining about the pressure of the ball, it seems, right?
So it looks like.
Well, I didn't know what she was throwing it in.
Christian Guerrero kicks it out.
Ooh.
Christian is way out into his own field as well. He's a forward. So let's see what San Antonio can do here to spread out.
Yes.
There seems to be our first injury of the match. Let's see who that is for the serve.
Well, he quickly gets up, and that seems to be...
Let's see, where's the ball at? Oh.
I believe that was Felipe Perez, midfielder for the serve.
There it is. Got the ball. Streamers.
Here comes Orange, trying to put some pressure. Number 20, Alexander Milor. Trying to chase the ball, make sure that they don't come. Oh, number 18 almost makes that mistake. Jason Torres with the miss kick. Fortunately, the blue was not able to catch onto that ball that goes out into the sideline. And once again, we're back into the orange 5-yard line.
We've gone 15 minutes into the game, Christian, and it seems that the serve have controlled the ball most of the time. However, the San Antonio Runners defense is holding up so far.
They're holding up very good at the moment. Now, I'm going to make a quick observation, Chris, and I'm not sure if the camera would appreciate, but if you can see that American flag out in the distance as well as the corner flags, there is a lot of wind movement. I'm assuming it will be at least a 15-mile-per-hour wind going against the orange, so I'm not sure if that is affecting where the ball is being placed at the moment.
I see that too, Christian, and that is a very good observation.
You want the injury?
Windy. Mm-hmm. We have another injury down at the field at the moment.
It looks like
is an orange player.
Alexander Milauer. And he's up.
Sana, sana, colita de rana, and let's get on with the game.
The defense for the Runners has held well, and here comes our first advance, and it's a kickball out of bounds.
Okay. I'm not sure if he was trying to compensate for the wind there. The ball did not do him any favors, and we're back into the field. It should be an orange ball.
Christian Torres passes the ball back to Jason Torres to throw the ball in.
Mason Burley. Alexander there putting some pressure, but now the orange, they're starting to get into blue territory little by little.
Here comes Jonathan
A couple
Esquivel.
Little finesse skills by Jonathan Esquivel.
Right,
there will be another throw in for the orange, who now move it to the blue territory. Looking to do their first damage here.
Alexander Milauer heads it back.
The blue will get the ball back to keeper Vincent Florio, who has the ball now. Switching the field to the left. Looking to come out, Alexander pushing forward. What Orange needs to do is maintain that same pressure movement to avoid any blue counterattack into their own field. Here comes number 24. Jorge Encinas looking to the move. Orange making that pressure up.
How do they hear me, though?
And I think that's what we wanted to see is Orange trying to risk a little bit. Alexander coming back into position. Another miss touch by Jason Torres there, who misses on another pass. Blue have the ball. Clear it. Number 9, Alec Rodriguez. Passes it to number 6, Miggy Salazar. Shoulder to shoulder challenge there for nice. Oh, it almost seemed like it was a nice pass by number 25, Christian Sekshaw. But it will end up being an orange ball. Little by little, attendance-wise is increasing, Chris, and I'm happy to see a good support for the San Antonio Runners side. I bet a lot of family members, friends as well, and of course fans that are coming out for this first inaugural home game of the season. Chris, what do you think?
Yes, a lot of support for this team and in soccer in general. We're seeing a very tough and close game so far, and I see that the runners they have made a couple of adjustments. I've seen Jelani Moore, he's pressing and touching the ball a little bit more.
Oh, Jose Torres getting the ball back, making that pass that I was mentioning about, from passing it from left to right, down low, here it comes,
goal! For the Surf, and they take the lead early, 1-0. Christian, the defense did let the runners down that time, and the ball went centered and was hit very well by the Surf.
That was what I was saying from the very beginning, Chris. They have to make sure that they don't allow those passes to the top of the 18, and that's exactly what happened. Number 10, Cohen Voss, simply reads that out very well and just makes that one touch shot into the net, a little bit too hard for Oscar Ceballos to stop, which causes the ball to go to the upright and into the net. 1-0 opener for the Surf.
All right, well, the runners are attempting to counter and strike back. Alexander Millauer looks like he will be attempting this free kick about 15 yards out. And let's see if we can
just look
see.
At that wind. Look That's at that wind. He's going to have to compensate. Here comes a kick. Oh! To the upper right. And that would be offsides.
Very good.
Or we're looking. No. It would be a corner kick, as it seems that it hit the upper right of the goal itself, and then it bounced off the three-point goal for the football. So it would be a corner there. Alexander with the left footer. Oh, so close there. Was an orange shirt in the middle to try to hit that, but pretty good clearance from Blue. Number 10 and all that fiasco, all that traffic for the Surf. Adrian Maldonado tries to survive the ball little by little. Number 17 gets it. Christian Guerrero looking for Alexander on the right side of the field. Left footer into the box to be quickly rejected by the Surf. Number 9 from the orange, looking Julio Franco, trying to get that ball back, putting that pressure to the Surf in their own field. And little by little, they are able to widen up those passes, widen up that line, and release that dangerous attack from the runners.
I do see the runners advancing. Jelani Moore and the midfielders are pressing a little bit more and trying to counter and get a strike back and tie this game.
Very quick response from the orange team to try to get that goal. Unfortunately, that upper right by Alexander on that free kick. Left footer, just like Messi would do it. He almost bent it in. It was close to being a golazo. But we are 1-0 at the 23rd minute. 1-0 for the Surf. Goal by number 10, Cohen Voss. very good game that is picking up. Like I said, it's a lot windy. And here comes number 9, the serve on the right side of the field, being rejected by Cristian Guerrero. Out into the field, a blue ball, again on the 10-yard line. Here comes another dangerous attempt for the serve. Ooh. Number 13 there, Felipe Perez, tries to cross it in, but I think the wind just jetted it out of the field. Oh, dangerous move here by the runners, but very good touch by number 21. Matthew Banda would try to clear it out, but forced the play in what could have been a very dangerous situation for the Orange.
So we will see a goal kick from Oscar Ceballos. Let's see if the runners can regroup again and create a new striking opportunity.
Looking for that long pass into the midfield, Alexander. Looking for support from number 7, Pape Sar, who's unable to provide another play, and the Orange team has to
surrender the ball
to the blue team.
Here we go, Giolani Moore, he's pressing forward. Let's see if he can get some support from his fellow midfielders. Here we go.
Good numbers the Orange has up in the field. Oh, and not quick enough release for the runners who try to recover on a very dangerous situation here. Number 12 trying to get the ball, Joseph Maldonado. But here comes Oscar Ceballos to clear the ball out. That's another save for the Orange team, who seen that they were not standing up correctly. They were not well situated at the moment.
The wind really have to push the ball forward on that one.
They have to pick up and compensate for that wind. They have to throw their numbers a little bit further back to avoid those ugly bounces by the ball. The surf maintaining their line quite well here in their own half. Switching over to the right side of the field. Number 25, Christian Sekschau. Looking for a play to the left side. Number 23 of the blue. Oh, here comes a cross. Costly mistake by Jason Torres.
It wasn't cleared.
Oh, it seems like he's injured. I think Jason Torres might be injured after trying to clear that ball. He is still down.
To advance.
So the Orange are down one player. I don't think the ref has seen Jason Torres stretching out his leg, asking for medical attention. And there goes the ref, stopping the game. I think there might have been a situation where he was trying to clear the ball, but I think there was a blue shirt that stepped on him.
I think you're right. That's why they didn't clear it clearly. Clear it cleanly on that attempt. There are some runners warming up on the bench. Let's see if we are going to have our first substitution.
Coach Mason Rankin also talking to his players. I think he sees what needs to be done in the switches. Jason Torres comes out. Shin guard in hand. Limping, it seems. Coming in will be number 10 for the Orange. Who received a couple of instructions.
Adrian Maldonado.
Actually, yes. Adrian Maldonado was receiving a couple of instructions by Coach Mason. Blue ball again, looking for that dangerous cross. Clean header by the serve. Number 13, Felipe Perez, with that strong header that just went a little bit over the crossbar. And that pressure just keeps on going, keeps on mounting for the serve. Orange tries to answer back, but they're back into playing in their own side of the field. Oh, what a nice touch here by the serve. One on one.
There goes the
second.
We have our second goal of the day coming from the serve, and now it is 2-0.
What a great play by the San Antonio serve there. Kickoff again. Runners down 2-0 now after that play by the surf at the 30th minute. Goal by number 9, Alec Rodriguez, forward from the Blues, puts the 2-0.
Alexander Millauer is attempting to steal the ball. Let's see if more runners do also push forward.
I see 5 defenders at the moment for the Oranges. Down, I think Coach Mason needs to risk a little bit of biscuit here. Try to move up at least one of the players into the midfield. Try to ease off that contention for the ball. Here comes Pape. Looking for number 11. Great play by number 11. Looking up, switching to the left side of the field. Alexander fighting for the ball and loses it to two shirts. Here comes the Blues. Number 6, making that big stretch into the box, takes the shot and just barely grazes the outside of the net. Another close call for the Orange team there. This is number 9, actually. Number 9 in that last play, Alec Rodriguez, looking for his second goal of the night.
Oscar Ceballos is getting a lot of action in the first 32 minutes of the game. Christian, what adjustments can the runners make in the short term to possibly make a goal this next 13 minutes?
Well, Chris, as we can see, we've seen a lot of plays on the outsides. I see a lot of movement on the outsides. Here comes some substitutions for the runners, or at least the bench starting to warm up. We have Alexander out of laying down on the field, complaining about his shoe, or complaining about his left foot. In the bench currently, we have Jacob Mendoza, Manuel Coya, Pape Sarr, Michael Middleman, Jose Hernandez, Matthew Panda, and Neyman Naidu, who are the backup man for the Orange. Oh no, number 21 loses the ball in his own field. Here comes Alec Rodriguez. Oh, what a save. What a save from Oscar Ceballos. If he did touch it, if not, that was a great flying block. Unfortunately, it lands on Orange feet. quick cumber counterattack. Number 17 looking for number 11 on the right side of the field. Here comes the cross and ends up in the keeper's hands for number one, Vincent Florio, who tells his team, slow down, slow down. We're winning this. Number 11 from the orange team, Jonathan Esquivel, putting up the pressure on the right side of the field, along with number 17, Christian Guerrero, fighting for that ball. With the absence of Alexander Miller, Chris, I don't see Alexander on the field anymore. I think he's complaining. He's still, I see him complaining about his left foot at the moment, too. He's starting to take off his sock.
That's right, Christian.
I'm not sure if he's going to be able to come back to the game.
I think you're right, and we do see more runners warming up out past the goal of the surf in the back. And let's see if we have a substitution for forwards, as it seems that earlier in the game, Jason Torres was also injured. So let's see what type of attack the runners do create, but they are trying hard, and the referee does call for a foul near the 20-yard mark outside of the goal. Let's see if the runners can create a new opportunity, as their last free kick did hit the crossbar.
Still windy conditions, as you can see, even on the players' shirts. See that flapping on their shirts. Trying to figure out what kind of wind speeds we're getting. Even the ball being steady moves backwards, Chris, as you can see. So that makes it a little bit more difficult for the runners to land a couple of crosses over. We'll see, and after the first half, with the switching of the field, things change for the runners. Here comes a great cross-in for the orange Burley gracing. The ball is number 16, Jelani Moore. Burley misses the ball getting there, but if he gets the ball, that was a one-on-one situation for him, and possibly the 2-1. Misread cross there by the Blues. Number 27 tried to get that ball, but the ball just goes overhead, and here comes another opportunity for the orange. Number 6, Manuel Coya, looking to throw this ball in. I think he's going to go wide. He ends up playing it for number 10, Adrian Maldonado. And here comes the Blues. It's blue ball now in their own half. Putting some pressure. It's Pape.
Very good.
Nice clear by Vincent Florio, who lands the ball at the 30-yard line for the orange to kick out. It would be blue ball at the 30. Orange dropping back, only leaving number 17, Christian Guerrero, up at the top. Most of the team is landing in the back, Chris.
Yes, the Surf are trying to get their third goal this half, and let's see if the runners can stop them. They still have the ball on the runner's side of the field, and they keep the ball as the runners kick the ball out of bounds. I do not see any Surf players warming up currently, so they're sticking with their starting lineup.
Another clear opportunity from number 21, Matthew Banda, who seemed to be hurting after that cleared kick. It would be a devastating injury if Matthew is not able to handle the physique. Oh no, here comes a shot Fortunately, Oscar Ceballos is there to hold the ball. But readily available was the Blues' number nine, Alec Rodriguez, looking for his second goal of the night.
Right, Christian, and look at that ball. It barely moved forward as the wind continues to push the ball in the Serbs' favor, and they continue to have possession.
Possession back in the middle of the field, blue ball. Christian Guerrero
dangerous
lost his
ball.
Shin guard. It's quickly an orange ball. Nice recovery by number 24 of the Blues, Jorge Encinas. Very, very active is Jorge out on the field, blocking any opportunity of passes from the orange team. Is back to being a blue ball on the sideline. Ball in, a nice control by Miggy Salazar. Tries to make an opportunity on the left side of the field. It will be orange ball back again. We're approaching the 40th minute now. We'll have to see. We had two injuries on the field. We'll have to see how much the refs are willing to add for stoppage time. But I think at this point, the orange team runners needs to regroup and go into halftime to slow things down for the Surf if they want to counter the 2-0 currently score. But here comes an opportunity for number 17. It is a great shot, and he barely misses it. Number 17, Christian Guerrero, is unable to put it into the net. Clear opportunity by the runners. And here comes a counterattack for the Surf.
And offside flag goes up.
Oh, it's an offside. It's just barely by a hair. But coming back, Christian Guerrero had that. The ball, unfortunately and unluckily, bounces a little too high up for him to head it into the net. Chris, that's the wind condition. That was the wind condition that stopped the ball from going in. That was an opening score for the runners.
Yes, second chance to score and a second very close opportunity that the runners had. Let's see if they can actually execute on their attacks and put one in before the end of the first half.
Nice switch of the field to the right by Daniel Odia of the Surf. But quick recovery for the runners. Ceballos needed to clear that, but he compromised into just passing it shorthandedly. And now they're fighting for the ball over at their own 10-yard line. Not sure why Ceballos didn't clear that. You try to get a good counterattack. Thank you for our 27 viewers watching us now through YouTube and all of our other platforms as well. Thank you for tuning in and watching this game. Lovely night here at the Wheatley Heights Sports Complex in San Antonio, Texas. Good game so far, 2-0 by the San Antonio Surf, by the Blues. Goals by Alec Rodriguez at the 30th minute and by Christian Sekchow, number 25 of the visiting team, that puts the Surf up 2-0. Coming up into the 43rd minute now. We'll see how much the refs are willing to give here for stoppage time. Gotta go ahead and take a guess, Chris, that we're gonna get about a minute or so of stoppage time, not a lot. of injury time, but we'll for sure get 1 minute in. Now that is to say that we still need the confirmation from the refs. Oh, what a nice cross and missed opportunity by number 24, Jorge Encinas, who headed it just inches to the left of the post of Oscar Ceballos, who just watches it fly by. A missed opportunity by the serve and a very, very lucky situation from the orange to keep it 2-0. That would have been the 3-0 score, compromising score to be going into the halftime. Pepe, oh, what a nice autopase by number 7 of the orange, Pepe Saar, who tried to make an opportunity but gets stopped by the serve at the 20-yard line. Not a lot of players playing upfield for the orange. Currently it's just
settling for this score.
Number 17, Christian Guerrero. Christian Guerrero playing forward. And number 11, Jonathan Esquivel, playing on the right side of the field.
The referee is signaling 2 minutes.
2 minutes of added time. 2 minutes of stoppage time, and we'll see a corner come in for the orange team. Jonathan Esquivel to take the kick. We're in stoppage time now. A minute into stoppage time, 1 minute to go. A lot of discussion for Coach Mason Ranking on his players. We'll see what kind of adjustments he will try to make here to stop these passes, just these passes. Nice filter here. The Blues get a lucky bounce. A shot off of number 23, Elias Dadi, who lands the ball into Oscar Ceballos' hands, accumulating opportunities. The runners clear the ball out and are playing now on the 40-yard line of the Blues, trying to make an opportunity but lose the ball. Recovering it is number 10, Adrian Maldonado, in the midfield. Last opportunity here for the runners. And they'll go out of bounds. I think we'll be hearing the whistle here from the ref after this play-in. No, it seems we keep going for a couple more seconds. Approaching the 48th minute now. I think the refs lied to us, Chris.
Yes, it's going. Let's see. It
prolonging that. Orange asking for that whistle now.
Yes.
They need to go into halftime. They need to
They cannot give up a third goal, but
here comes the bounce for the serve. Oh, and what a lucky clear. There to try to recover the ball was number 6, Miggy Salazar for the Blues. But just misses it by a couple of inches and lands in the midfield. 48 minutes of playing time now. We keep going. The ref looks at his watch, trying to see how much time he has left. Come on. 48-30. I don't think we're going to get lunch tonight, Chris.
You're right, Christian. We're getting close to the actually the 49th minute of this half. Let's see if we can get another goal before the second half begins.
Oh, what a nice opportunity here by number 23 of the blue, who receives the ball. He's clearly onside. Orange trying to recover. Still blue ball. And the runners clear it out into the field. Oh, switching positions.
And
a mistake that the ref is able to cover up by calling halftime. There is a halftime whistle at the 49th minute. 4 minutes of stoppage time. And we are into halftime. Lots of discussion by Coach Mason Ranking. Very good job by the San Antonio Serve, who are able to keep up the score 2-0 at the moment. 2-0 into halftime. Now, again, Chris, we have to take in consideration weather conditions. I think it's a lot more windy. I think it's a lot more windy than what it needed to be for the San Antonio runners. Now, I'm not sure if they had a choice to pick a side of the field. I'm not clear about that, but I think given that situation, they should have opted for starting off on the other field that had the wind not against them to be able to avoid the score. I think that a wind has a pretty good factor. What do you think?
That's very true. Let's see if the second half is showing any type of resurgence from the runners. But being that these are two San Antonio teams and shows a lot of San Antonio talent, the two goal scorers of the night was a Trinity University All-American and a UIW soccer player. But the runners also have showed really good class and two attempts at goals, very close. What did you see from those two near goals from the runners?
Unlucky, for one. Again, I'm deep into the factor of the wind. The first scoring opportunity from Alexander of the runners landed in the crossbar. But I think given a little bit more speed into that ball, that would have cleanly gone into the net. The second opportunity was from Christian that he just could not control the ball. It was a high bounce, which he could have just easily hit it in into the net. But unfortunately, that keeps the score 2-0 at the moment. And I'm seeing a lot. I'm just, regardless of those opportunities, Chris, I think I'm seeing a lot more activity from the Surf at the moment. I think the blue team is being able to play more in the runners' side of the field. Lack of opportunities is what keeps the team just playing in one half. I think Coach Mason needs to regroup his alignment and switch his lines to play a little bit more aggressive. You're down 2-0. I think you just, at this point, you need to risk it, because if goal number three lands with the way things are going, it's going to be very hard to turn this game around.
Yes, and I have not seen a lot of attacking opportunities for the runners. Now, when they have had their best chances at goal have been from free kicks, corner kicks, and really it's only been those two chances. What can the runners do to create more scoring opportunities, more free kicks, more corner kicks, more attacks? What can they do with these injuries as the forward Milgar is seems to be hurting as a left foot?
Playing, I think that they discovered a little bit that playing on both sides of the field would be a key factor in getting a couple of more opportunities. But let's go. We'll wrap this up for now. We'll leave you guys hanging for a little bit here while we come back for the second half of the game. Stick around. Don't leave. And we'll see you here on the second half of the San Antonio Runners home game.
It's time for a dedicated women's league to fill the gap between college and professional soccer. a league that's committed to advancing women's soccer, focusing on the development of the female soccer player during the summer months, elevating the competition to help each player reach that next level, providing high-level soccer for collegiate players, aspiring and former professionals, and international stars, operating with professional standards because players and fans deserve an exceptional experience, uniting players that inspire and are inspired. We are passionately growing the women's game. The future is bright for United Women's Soccer. It's time. Be part of the movement.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for having me to the San Antonio Runners Soccer Club. My name is Abigail Velez, and I am the reigning Miss San Antonio USA. Again, I'm so excited to be here. From what I've seen, it's been an excellent production. Both soccer teams came out to play, and of course, I am enjoying all the festivities that we have here today, the amenities like the people, the performers, and speaking of which, we have a very important band here to play for y'all. We have San Antonio's number one cover band, and that is the Hitz. They are here based in San Antonio. They're going to have an excellent production from you, and they should be coming up right in a little bit.
How's it going, everybody? Hope you're enjoying your evening. We are the Hitz. I'm going to play some jams for you.
Thank you.
First home game of the season for the San Antonio Runners SC against the San Antonio Surf. Current score 2-0. The Blues up on the scoreboard. Chris, what do you think of the alignment for this second half? Do you see any changes into the field?
I do, Christian. See a couple of adjustments. I do see the goalie has changed as well as a couple other positions. Let's see if this can help the Runners get a goal and get closer to tying this match. We haven't seen too many fouls called this game, Christian. Do you think that the Runners can push the ball, get some free kicks, get some corner kicks, and really that's where they've had the most action and best opportunities to score? Do you think they can do that with this alignment that you see right now?
Well, given the change of the field now, and I've said this throughout the night, changing the field for that wind advantage might make the difference, as we see here, Pape Saar trying to take that shot. So utilizing and compensating for that wind might make a difference. We'll see here in the next couple of minutes. But also what we need to see is a little bit more action on the outside fields. Utilize the left and the right a little bit more, spread out. As you can see in the field at the moment, it's saturated. So you need to widen up those numbers and risk a little bit of biscuit by having at least one more player up in the field and avoid that saturation at the bottom. So that's what the San Antonio Runners SC needs to do.
Yes, and I do see a stop in play, so it seems like there is a foul called, and the runners are having that free kick opportunity, which they had a lot of success in the first half. Christian, let's see if this free kick opportunity does lead to a scoring opportunity for the runners.
Number seven with the runners here, kicking indirect. Oh, I think he tried to go for too much on that kick, or if the wind overkicked it. Pape Sarr, very powerful kick that goes for a three-point conversion. The Blues back with the ball, but quickly recovered by the runners.
We can already see that the possession is leading more towards the left side of the field on our side here, now being the runner's possession. And let's see if this leads to a goal or even an equalizer on the second half.
Blue ball at the moment. Number 15 taking it out of the sidelines. Nice change of field, a great first touch by the serve. Switch over to the left side of the field. Switching back and forth. Secrets, this is what I'm talking about when it comes to widening those angles. But they quickly lose that ball, trying to get that opportunity in. Number 25, who substitutes Oscar Ceballos. Number 25, Neyman Naidu.
Christian, and it looks like another forward for the runners is down. Christian Guerrero is down. He collided with the goalie for the serve, and it does seem that the runners' forwards have been getting injured tonight.
They've been having a rough night. Alexander Millard has gone out of the game early on as well. One of the power forwards that the runners SC has, and they've lost him. Christian had a opportunity in the first half. Christian Guerrero, number 17, he gets up now. Coming back to that missed opportunity that he had in the first half. Could be promising second half, but he needs that physique. He needs to maintain, keep himself out of trouble from injuries. I see him limping a little bit. Not sure what's going on here. I think it's a friendly blue ball. Oh no, the ref gets in! Christian had the opportunity to get that ball, but fair play in place allows the ball to remain in the Blues position.
I like what I'm seeing though from the runners. They're really pushing it in the direction of a goal, and hopefully they can capitalize on some either like bounces because of the wind or and the tactics for the offense. I don't know, Christian, what do you think? Do you see the wind playing another factor, or as the night continues to get towards the later in the evening, do you think the wind will continue to play a factor, or do you think it will die down?
I think the San Antonio runners, they need to be patient. Be quick with the plays, yes, but they need to cool their heads. See here, they're having a hard time coming out. They need to widen these numbers. They need to spread the field out and just able to provide some opportunities here. Bad crossover here for the orange, and now it's back to being a blue ball. Now, Chris, I do see a slight change in the line. Previously, I was noticing that the runners were playing with five defenders at one time. And now it seems that the lines have shifted a little bit to just having four down at the bottom. Dangerous plays here by the serve, who extend the ball to the left side of the field, looking for that dangerous play. Top of the 18, quickly rejected by the runners outside of their own box. Number 15 having the ball on the right side of the field. Picking his head up is number 6 of the serve, Miggy Salazar, who plays it towards the back, towards the goalkeeper, who switches it over to the left to number 24. Jorge Encinas plays it back to Vicente Vincent Florio. Nice recovery by the runners, and here comes the first opportunity. Clear opportunity by Christian Guerrero, who I believe was offsides, so this play did not count anyways. But he tried to cut to the right side of the field. I'm not sure if the ball was getting out of his feet, if he did not have control to just get that kick out. It's still offsides. That does not count. But that could have been one of the most clear opportunities to bring the score down to just one. We remain 2-0. Serve at the 53rd minute. Clearly changing things up is the orange team now, who are playing more aggressive into the blue territory. I haven't seen that much action other than the last previous play that the serve had, but not as dangerous at the moment in these first 8 minutes of the second half. Good play by number 10 of the serve. Gets the ball back, tiki-taka. Picking the head up. Oh, nice play, 1-2 touch there, triangulation. Playing it to the right side of the field is number 15, looking for that through pass, but there it is. Orange goalkeeper, Neyman Naidu, getting the ball back for the runners. Finding that opportunity there, the left side of the field. Orange get the ball, but not soon enough before the ref whistles a foul. Right at the middle of the field, the 50th yard line. It's blue ball again. Oh, nice. Nice pass, long pass for number 15, playing it on the right. Pape Sar.
Great steal right there.
Pape Sar trying to get a little bit of defensive movements going on. In the midfield, not sure if he saw whose ball it would be. It's orange ball now. From the sideline, Pape trying to recover, loses it, but recovers it again. And here comes an opportunity. Turns Christian Guerrero, but quickly denied by the serve. Recovered by number 6, Miki Salazar. And here comes a one-on-one situation, but it's offsides. Offsides, another save. Another save for the orange. That is a second knock on the door in this second half for the blues. Excellent cross to the right side of the field. Ooh, some Ronaldinho movements there by number 11. Looking for that opportunity. Jonathan Esquivel with the high skill moves. And here comes an offside. Offside for the runners. Good movement there by Jonathan Esquivel. Crossing over his legs, trying to make a play out of it. Providing some show for the fans. The serve, looking for those high ball lead passes.
Great tackle by Jelani Moore.
There comes Jelani Moore. Looking for number 10. Adrian Maldonado on the left side of the field, trying to get an opportunity. It'll be orange ball now. Switching the field over to the right. Nice recovery by Jonathan Esquivel again. Blue ball now in the middle of the field, switching it over to the left. Rejection by the runners. Nice performance by the Hits during halftime. Chris, what did you think of the cover songs?
Excellent. Excellent. Enjoy. And good rock songs. I thought I was back in the band hero days and the guitar hero days. I thought those were some really good hits from the Killers and a couple other.
There goes my hero, right? There goes my hero. Yes. There goes the ball. That's my hero trying to get number 13. Nice. Denied by Matthew Banda. Kicks it out to the side of the field. Blue ball. Once again, thank you for 34 viewers that we had on YouTube. Appreciate that. Thank you for tuning in. And for everybody that is here tonight showing support. Here comes the first yellow card of the game for the Blues. Not sure who the card belonged to. I believe it was for, here comes the ref. Comes the ref trying to look for the player here. I believe it was for number 9, Alec Rodriguez of the blue team. Another just wasted ball for the orange. That is the kind of patience that I'm talking about. They need to think that this second half is a 0-0 situation. Be able to just provide, they gotta use that win, Chris, to their advantage, but on specific opportunities, kicking the ball too high up like that is just gonna take the ball away and not allow for your players, for your forwards to have better control. So I think what they have to do is use that to their advantage for kicking it outside the box. Here comes Pape, but not in a timely manner to get the ball, which is quickly rejected by the surf. Coming back to what I was saying with the wind situation, Chris, I think it would be good to kick it just barely outside the box, but not when you're halfway of the field. It's not gonna allow for a good control of the ball by the orange team. So they have to be smart about how they utilize that wind to their advantage.
Yes, the first free kick they had did go way over the goal, and then this second opportunity did as well. They just need to make some adjustments now that we are 15 minutes into the second half, Christian. But here we go with another free kick, and let's see if they can adjust and get a shot on goal. Let's see.
Nice crossover, but denied by Blue. Oh, Pape putting that pressure. They have to come back. Orange has to come back and put out of that pressure, but Blue quickly recovers on their own field, looking to get a little bit stress off the ball. They opt out to switch it to the left side of the field, but a little bit too aggressive the pass, and it's now runner's ball. That should be a foul.
Very aggressive push from Daniel Odia, as he did push one of the runners from the back, but it was just a foul. And now here comes another free kick for the runners past half mark, and let's see if they can get the ball in the territory of a shot on goal. We haven't seen a good shot on goal to test Benson Florio this evening besides those two opportunities in the first half.
Daniel Odia there with the foul, push from the back. A member of the Alamo SC team. Golazo by the runners. The first one of the night to cut that lead from the serve. It is a 2-1 score now.
The wind playing that a major wind, factor tonight.
That wind factor was beneficial there. I believe it was. Trying to see the shirt number. Number 17, Christian Guerrero. Christian Guerrero provides that header into the net. 2-1 now at the 63rd minute. Well played from the middle of the field from that foul.
Here we go. Now
here comes the second opportunity. Christian Guerrero calls offsides. I don't know, Chris, if it was offsides.
That would have been a crucial equalizer just 1 minute after the goal from the runners. But let's see, there is still 30 minutes left in this game.
I don't know if it was offsides, Chris. Very close call. Unfortunately, we don't have the angles, the camera angles, to see whether or not it was just by a hair. Really, we'll have to trust the officials on that. Clear opportunity in 2 minutes. Actually, no, in 1 minute. Almost two clear opportunities to level the game out. Christian Guerrero, number 17, who almost was injured back in the 50th minute, Chris.
Yes.
We're talking about that, but here comes another opportunity, 23rd, no! Here comes the second, the third goal. Third goal of the surf of the night.
What a counter from the surf.
Counter from the Blues towards the left side of the field. And number 23, Elias Dadi receives it for a one-on-one situation with Naimana Naidu. But it's quickly defeated.
That was
by
a
low shot
for the
to the right.
Right there, Christian.
The runners had great momentum. That's right, Chris. The runners had great momentum, and what it seems that it was almost an equalizer for the orange team. Ends up in a 3-1 situation now. We're back to a 2-goal difference now. 2 goals in 2 minutes. Elias Dadi from the serve, well positioned, well located, and well read. Looking for that ball in the area and was just by himself at the end there.
Christian, that was their first attack in this second half, and it was executed to perfection. It was pretty much just blindsided. The defense from the runners seemed to be unexpecting of this attack, and the goal was made by the serve, and now they're back up by two, but let's see if the runners can strike back. Let's see this free kick opportunity, and it is cleared and out of bounds, and it is still runner's ball.
Interesting counterattack. We'll have to review that, but that pass came from the left side of the field. There was nowhere inside, no orange shirts inside from the left side of the field, and it was a nice clean pass towards the midfield where number 23 Elias Dadi was able to just receive it.
Ball has changed hands, and now the serve take over. And let's see if the runners can find a way to get the ball back and in to scoring position. Let's see. And they do not.
The ball goes out of bounds.
Oh, they did. Runners have
40-yard line,
possession.
And it's a ball now for the runners. pretty good game so far, though, Chris. We've seen a lot of action, some good goals. Both teams are sweating.
Yes.
It's a good night here in San Antonio for some soccer. Aside from the win situation that we currently have, ball in the middle of the field. Here comes Pape, who tries to recover the ball, but is unable to, and it will be blue ball. Back on their own half. Christian Guerrero trying to surprise the blue team, but is unable to get the ball. Elias Daddy here. Daddy driving the ball. Trying to get it to his teammate over on the left side, but misses it. Number 19, Ryan Jacinto, who went to O'Connor High School, and is also from San Antonio. Jacinto there. I believe Ryan Jacinto was the one that provided the assist to Daddy for the 3-1. Approaching the 69th minute now. A little more action, Chris, from the orange team. Unfortunate that they scored a third goal. But a little more action from the orange team here. Daddy trying to look for the ball on the right side of the field. Still plenty of time for the runners to level things out. One goal could change the dynamic, bringing it back mentally wise. Oh, the ball goes out of bounds just inches for number 27, Eric Olvera. A player of Dinwood University men's soccer team. Chris, if you're Coach Mason, what's going through your mind at the moment?
I like what I saw at the beginning of the second half, Christian, with that strike early, but that counter from the serve did hinder this momentum that we had. I do like the substitutions that we made to give us some energy because of the injuries, because we did have significant injuries in the forward position. We still were able to create goal scoring opportunities, but I feel like guys like Jelani Moore, who has been more on the defense, you see him running fast back there. I when I see him pushing the field forward, that's when they had the opportunity to score. So I'm looking more at that center defense section there to see if they can possibly push the ball forward, as the runners have had multiple injuries both in the first half and the second half.
Foul given to the Blues. To the surf. Should be their third attempt for a free kick. Here comes Dadi with the opportunity for a free kick. 25 yards out. Direct hit into the hands of runner's keeper. Naidu with the block.
They cleared the ball out, Christian, and now the goalie for the serve has the possession. Let's see what type of counter, what type of movement the runners can have here on this side of the field.
Stay
Pape, a substitution in this game is crucial for the success of the runners here, as they have already scored, but they need to score two more to equalize this game. Let's see if they can do it.
Naidu again with the ball. Recovers it well. Ooh, instant pressure from number 14 of Surf. Compromising situation there for the runners, but very well played, although with a hint of gutsiness by the runners' defender. Does a Ravona-style pass, and what's going on here for the Surf?
That was a
miscommunication there.
Let's see if
and it will be runner's ball. Yep, runner's ball at the 30-yard line. Jelani Moore. Good move by Jelani Moore. And that last play, number six loses the ball, but Jelani Moore recovering it there. Foul on number 10. Adrian Maldonado. Yeah.
Number 10, Adrian Maldonado from Earl Warren High School here in San Antonio, and Texas Lutheran men's soccer from Seguin seemed to get injured, but he's back up, and let's see if he can create a goal scoring opportunity for the runners. Here we go from the free kick.
Pape on the ball. Into the line, miscommunication there by the runners.
That has
Jelani Moore, great recovery. Almost reminds me of his playing style, almost reminds me of Alexander Arnold from Liverpool.
Jelani's been playing well this evening, and let's see if he can help the runners. Christian, like you said earlier about the patience, I feel like that play right there had more opportunities than to create a goal-scoring opportunity, but let's see what the runners can come up with here with 15 minutes to go, Christian.
Jelani Moore playing great defensively, though. Reminds me of Liverpool's player, Virgil van Dijk. Great player for Liverpool, great physique, and that's what seems Moore has here. Counterattack, great moves by number 14. On the right side of the field, still keeps the ball, but is unable to retain it. It will be a goal kick for the runners. As we approach the 75th minute now, you can see a little bit of pressure mounting up for the runners. Pape on the ball on the left side of the field, looking to push it up forward a little bit. Jelani Moore leaving his defensive position to play a little bit more up. As you can see, number 16 there playing forward now. I think it's Coach Mason trying to put things a little bit more aggressive for the Blues. Nice through ball here. One-on-one situation for the San Antonio Surf. Would it be a 4-1? 4-1! Number 14 of the Blues extends the score in a fashion matter. Tunelito y adentro a la red. 4-1. Heads down for the team as number 10, my mistake, number 10, Cohen Voss, beautifully puts that with his right foot. Going past orange defender's legs and Nandi's hands, Naidu's hands, they extend the score 4-1. A devastating blow for the orange here on their first home team, home field game.
And Christian, we were just talking about Jelani Moore getting pushed up to try to possibly score, and the Serfs quickly countered on that attack, and they have not missed this second half, Christian. They have put those counters in, and the which started well for the runners this second half with that early score has been just taken back with the two goals from the Serfs right after that. Let's see if the runners can possibly get closer to getting another goal towards the end of this game, Christian. What do you think?
As we mentioned, Jelani was up playing as a forward. And I'm not sure if that was a coaching call, but he was up in the field playing as a second forward, leaving that precise middle field wide open. And just as we were mentioning that, a through ball goes in for Voss to just quickly gather. And that is the situation now. Pave with a shot, with a right footed shot. Tries to take advantage of the win situation. Barely goes over the crossbar. Good shot from Pape Sarr.
That was the second shot at goal that I can remember this second half, Christian. And Vincent Florio had the opportunity to hold it, but it did go out of bounds, and it is Serfs ball. Let's see what type of movement the runners can make to try to get the ball back into another scoring position. Bring it down first,
bring it down first. There's Jelani Moore again in the middle of the field, as you can see, Chris. Perhaps they'll learn, the defensive line will learn to cover that. But very good movement from Cohen Voss there. He's acting as a contention. He has the ball now, looks up. Great pass at this point. The Blues are playing offside. They're playing the offside advantage.
And oh, the offside
great reception. There's the offsides, but they are playing with the offside line, and they are giving the score that they're doing now. They are just simply playing to the extreme of the offensive line, and not caring if they're going to just be encroached by the offensive trap. They don't care anymore. They're playing those through balls without a care if they're going to get any kind of consequences. But we have a substitution on the field coming out on the Blues. It's number 23, Elias Dadi. Author of goal number 3. At the 65th minute, and in goes number 12, Sebastian Castellanos, who previously used to be a San Antonio Runners, and is now opting to play for the Blues. Coming out to the 82nd minute, 4-1.
The out-of-bounds flag does go up, and the possession sticks with the runners, Christian.
Ooh, unlucky bounds there, and a shot made by the Serf. I believe it was Cohen Voss again, wanted to look for his second goal of the night. Surf are not slowing down, even though they're up by 3. Hey, stop. Foul called out by the ref at the 30-yard line. Adrian Maldonado goes down. Should be a handball here. The ref misses a handball. Oh, through pass, but unfortunately doesn't land on Daniel Olia. It just lets it go by, thinking that it was going to be a long ball. Orange ball on their own half. Nice tiki-taka here. Good passes. Trying to get that opportunity. Runners come down. A bit of confusion out on the field with the refs. It would be blue ball now. There was a little bit of confusion whether it was going to be an orange ball or a blue ball.
Christian Guerrero is trying to get the ball back. He did have success on that goal early in the second half, but besides that, he has not had any possessions in this second half besides that one in the first 10 minutes, Christian. Christian Guerrero, he has been the forward that had success, but he really, now he has the ball. Let's see if he can find a way to get another scoring opportunity. Here he goes again. Let's see
good
if
opportunity
he can get
for
this
Orange.
Possession going.
Good opportunity for Orange on the right side of the field, looking for the 18. Pape Star. Having a little bit of a miscontrol there. It would be out into a goal kick for the serve. Had a promising opportunity there for the runners at the top of the 18. Into the feet of number 23. Serve still playing long balls, looking for situations like this for a mistake for the runners. They're not letting down.
They sure aren't, Christian. And that's kind of what got them on those counters, were just on the back end of the runners with Jelani Moore pushing it up. There does seem to be opportunities for that counter, but Jelani and the defense they were ready on that one opportunity. Let's see what happens here, as we do have another goal kick from Naeem Naidu.
There was a play, maybe two plays back, Chris, where I saw a through ball for the serve. I saw two forwards thinking that they were offsides. I did not see a flag with a clear intention of pulling the ball. The ref didn't bring out the flag. Did not end up in the feet of the Blues. But that's the kind of game that the surf are going for now, is those offensive traps. Offline traps. Playing long balls. Wind pushing out the ball. It will be blue ball from the goal. Although the ref is marking a side. Side throw in, huh? Oh no, not a side throw in. It would be an orange corner kick. My apologies. An orange corner kick for the runners.
Here's the best scoring opportunity the runners have had in the past few minutes. Let's see what happens, Christian.
Here comes the kick. Christian Guerrero barely missing it. Gracing the ball, and now it's a counterattack for the surf.
Another long ball, Christian.
Long ball and into the feet. Oh.
Naidu
there. Well placed. Very dangerous situation.
Let's see number 17.
Nice tunelito. No foul yet given.
See if number 17, Christian.
The ball in the middle of the field. Ready. Blue possession.
Another
nice long switch of the field. Naidu almost misses the ball. Tries to cover it outside the field and receives a punch from the Blues. Seemed that he received an elbow to the back. by number 12. The refs telling number 12 of the serve, Sebastian Castellanos, to not do that again.
Sebastian Castellanos, it shows that he used to play for the Runners, and he brought down Naidu there, and let's see if the Runners can find a way to put a goal in the net for the, before the end of this game, Christian.
Babe Sar with a bad pass, tries to recover now. Good body movement there, and a foul is given. Babe on the ground. Not sure if fatigue is starting to play a trick. Well, we're 2 minutes out from the 90th minute. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in for tonight's game of the Runners' home game here at the Wheatley Heights Sports Complex Stadium.
Let's see, Jelani Moore with the ball. He controlled it and has passed it to his teammate. Let's see if we can create another attack here, Christian.
I've not seen Jelani Moore touch the ball in a couple of minutes here. Nice side tackle by number 19 of the surf. Kicks it out of bounds, orange ball right at the 50-yard line. Jonathan Esquivel trying to make a move out of there. Michael Middleman in the game. He formed part of the FC Dallas Youth and Dallas Texans Youth teams. He also played for OK Wesleyan College. Michael Middleman, number 15 there. Well, he made a good sweeping defensive move there. Crossover into the middle of the field, top of the 18. Serve with another opportunity, rejected by the Runners. And here's Christian.
Let's see.
Christian fighting for his life with the ball. But gets a call out on the ref for shoving a blue defender there.
We have hit the 90th minute, Christian. Let's see, there haven't been as many stop and plays, so let's see how many more minutes the refs will add before the end of tonight's.
Naidu with a great throw, Pape Sar, not his night tonight. Is able to get a handball. Blue team being a little bit aggressive, not having any mercy to their team.
As this match comes to a near close, it's already past the 90th minute. I do want to thank everybody for watching this broadcast, and I also want to give a thank you to the Wizard, Chris, for directing our broadcast this evening, along with our team, Sean and Gavin, for putting this great broadcast together. And you know, it has been a very tough match for the Runners, but I do see that they have kept challenging the serve, and let's see if they can create one more scoring opportunity, oh. Christian.
Bad touch by number 23 as the serve trying to get a shot goes way over the crossbar. Number 23 also not having a good touch there. Almost counter. Countered by the surf team. Tries to look for a fifth goal here before the end of the game. As the ref calls it a night. Final score 4-1 for the San Antonio Surf over the San Antonio Runners SC here at the Wheatley High Stadium. 2 minutes of stoppage time. And that'll be all for tonight here in San Antonio, Texas, on a windy game that could have made a big difference for the blue team, who took advantage of that situation. But Christian Guerrero, number 17 of the orange team, puts one on the score. And I think both the teams had a great game tonight. Unlucky for the orange team. Couple more passes, a little more risk-taking for the blue team, who was able to equalize on that long and through passes that they were having, playing that offline, offsides line, and just risking, trying to either find a mistake by the orange team or a good counter-strike, and that's exactly what happened for the blue team.
Yes, Christian. And let's see if we can have an update later on Alexander Milauer, as he did get injured and had a close opportunity to for goal earlier, along with other injuries for the runners. But we want to keep an eye on them and come back with another great game soon.
Alexander came out about the 38th minute of the first half. You can see him there at the right side of the screen, no longer in frame, but he was there limping, had sandals on. And a lot of notes here to be taken by Coach Mason Rankin in this first home game. I think very productive game. I think it was good lessons to be learned by the orange team. They did not have an overall bad game. They provided for some opportunities. We had Alexander's hitting the crossbar in the first half. Christian missing that opportunity by an unlucky bounce that would have brought things up, maybe for a closer score, 2-1. Heads up, boys. But I think it is definitely something to take notes on. Change a little bit of alignment there. And see what else we could come out
That's
for the
right,
next game.
Christian. And we did get that one executed goal by the runners, which it did help close the gap at 2-1. But the Surf finished the game strong, putting another two goals on counters. But let's see. I know the runners will come back strong and will put together another great game, as their second half did have some adjustments. So let's see the injuries, how they play out, because the forwards were the ones that were affected mostly.
The injuries, I think the runners had a little bit more difficulty on the physique side. The blue team came a little bit more aggressive, more physical, and I think that was a factor for tonight's game. I've been saying this all night. The wind. The wind was off today. We're in an open field, so the ball seemed to have some kind of effect in a couple of the passes, and on top of the injuries that the runners were having. And I think they were just being too conservative, not releasing the ball too quickly. I think they were trying to look for better plays, but the players were not there, were not available. And so those things have to be shifted a little bit more to find that key movement of passes, that triangulation, that triage, that want to release the ball faster, widen up the field a little bit more, stop playing in your own field, and get the ball a little bit better, you know,
It was the first forwards. Game for the home season, so I did see some adjustments. Do you see any other takeaways for this first home game for this new season?
Just what I said there, and I'm not sure if being the first home game as well, if the team needs to learn from each other, learning how everybody moves, the players, the passes, and how everybody moves down the field. I think that was – I saw a lot of – static placement from the players, not enough field of movement, not enough clearance, and I think that was one of the other factors that also led to this result. Again, lessons to be learned. overall, a good game, a good attendance tonight, very good weather. Very excited for this new season for the Runners SC to be out, and I invite everybody to come out to play, not to play, to view the players and support your local team of San Antonio, and for all of your players that reside here in this beautiful city.
That's right, Christian. I wanted to also say, you know, being that it is the first game of the season, we're going to see the adjustments. But I want to really thank everybody that came out to the Wheatley Sports Complex, as well as all the viewers that were watching on streaming. We really appreciate it. Again, we want to thank our whole broadcast team. And any last words, Christian?
Nope. I think we're good. We'll see you on the next stream and the next game. And hope you guys can come out and join us. We'll leave you with the hits. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in. And thank you, everybody, for your support for the San Antonio Runners SC. We'll see you the next time.
Thank you. We'll be right back.